Hello there and welcome to Mid Chaos. So today we are going to be doing quests with Timon, and I'm sure the drama, plenty of drama, will unfold. So, let's get started. Oh, look, here's Pumbaa. Hi, Pumbaa. How's my baby doing?
He's so cute.
We just finished up Pumbaa's level 2 and level 4 quest, so I think we are moving on to Timon's level 7 quest. Okay, let's go find the most evil person in the entire valley. Hey, Pumbaa and I were just talking about you. I mean, because you're so nice and all. Oh, really, Timon? Really? You were talking about me because I'm nice.
No. No.
I seriously doubt that that's true, Timon. What were you actually saying? As you must know by now, I was an integral part of Simba's journey to embracing the king within himself. So it's all your fault he has main character syndrome. Because quite frankly, I wouldn't even define Simba as a narcissist. He's just like, he's more so egocentric, you know? You, Timon.
I'd like to talk to you.
Pumbaa, I'd love to talk to you, honey. I love him so much. I have so much love in my heart for Pumbaa. Anyway, Timon, so it's all your fault that Simba is the way he is. It explains a lot. It explains a lot.
Yeah.
Really, it does. What if I could do that for others here in the valley? Give them main character syndrome? Please don't. All these royals and leaders just wandering aimlessly with no one to guide them towards their true destiny until now? I just dropped the remote. And now it's getting a dramatic montage for me. I don't even have to make any shots. Hold on. Oh my god. Oh my god. We're gonna have to already make the lore video part 3. I thought it was gonna come in like a year from now, but these last few videos with just Timon alone. Just Timon alone, we're gonna have to make a part 3. He's trying to lead people into owning up to their, like, leadership. Or I don't really know how to word it, but, like, he wants people to become more powerful. It seems like he wants a certain group of people to become more powerful. Like, he wants to start... Sorry. Like, horrible angles. He wants to start his own little army, don't you, Timon? I can't make this up. I don't know what's coming. I don't know that these things are going to happen. I think... He's evil. He's evil. He's more evil than Mirabelle. I think Timon might be at the top. I think he's at the top. Okay, Timon, I'm concerned for my well-being and my husband's well-being and my son's well-being. I have a son now, Pumbaa, you know? The stakes are even higher than they were before because I have a baby. Baby Pumbaa. I call it a Timon talk of figure. Are you sure you can handle that? Public speaking can be tough, and quite frankly, you just can't capture an audience, Timon. Am I sure I can handle it? Huh, Jamie, didn't you hear me say I helped Simba on his king's journey? Yeah, that didn't work out. It really didn't work out. Okay, so what do I need to do? I need some kind of sign to advertise my talk to all the royals around here. This is dangerous. Okay, Eve's here. Eve, thank you, because he literally just said he's been looking for me, except I have to hang out with him, unfortunately. Ugh. But Eve's here. And I know that Jafar is looking after me. Jafar is the Mr. Darcy of my prayers. He is the Mr. Darcy that I've been praying for. He doesn't really look like Colin Firth. But he's my Mr. Darcy. He really is. Literally, where did Timon go? Timon, we were supposed to be hanging out. Not that I want to. I mean, you can... Oh, he's all the way in the glade. Why is he... Oh, my God.
The stupid meerkat!
Craft the Timon billboard? 4 Timon billboards? I wanna throw up. So we just need billboards of the entire EyeLuminati, because what, we have one with Mike and Vanellope. We have one with Timon. Like, do we see how the EyeLuminati just wants to put up pictures of themselves? Mirabelle made her portrait. Oh my God, I was gonna put them face towards a rock, but they're double-sided. Are you kidding me? Oh my God, okay. This is what we'll do. We'll put one behind the house in the shadows. Okay, there we go. They're out in the open so everyone can see them. You're welcome. Hey, Jamie, I heard you've been helping Timon with something. Yeah, unfortunately. I am, and it's going to be horrible. Absolutely horrible. Everybody should run for their lives. The idea is, Timon remembers how you overcame so much and learned to embrace being king. Now he wants to help others around Dreamlight Valley find some of that confidence so he can build an army and take over the world.
Ah.
That's great. He's really starting to find his place here, isn't he? Yeah. At the top of the EyeLuminati pyramid, that's for sure. I don't think I'm emotionally ready. Honestly. I don't know. What's gonna happen at this talk? Is it just gonna be like a roast or something? Oh? No, not Jack. What's Mirabelle's plan? I think they're called night thorns. Is she trying to harness the power of the night thorns? We have to keep Jack away from Mirabelle because he understands their power. And especially with Sally coming, she might try to join forces with Jack and Sally. And of course Beast is here because they keep trying to get Beast to join, but like it's not working. Mulan? The like protector of the valley? Look at this. He's starting a cult. What is this? He's starting a cult. Oh my, why is Donald here? No offense, Donald, but you're not really royalty. He probably just thinks he's royalty. You know what, Donald? I'm happy for you. Timon, what is this?
So,
what is this?
Up to, kid?
He's literally starting a cult. It's Timon talk time. How do you feel? Great, I'm glad you're here too, Jamie. As the ruler of this place, you'll probably learn a thing or two today. Nobody drink any Kool-Aid. Don't drink anything. Nobody drink anything. Don't eat anything either. Just keep your mouth shut. Tape them shut. Don't open them. Get ready to embrace your true potential. I'm gonna throw up. Welcome everyone to the first ever Timon Talk of the Valley, the last one. As Simba's right-hand meerkat, I've learned a lot about what it means to be a leader. That's my best pal! Aw, Pumbaa, you're so supportive. You deserve better. You see, when Pumbaa and I found Simba, we took him in and introduced him to new foods. Grubs. Don't yell at Pumbaa. Sorry, Pumbaa, don't apologize. Did he cry? Pumbaa! I could see my little cub growing into a fierce lion. We'd lie down and admire the fireflies in the sky. So, he was giving him something. I still have questions about that. He's not answering Pumbaa's questions. And finally, I coached Simba through his most difficult trial yet. Overcoming his past and defeating his uncle. And so I invite all of you to follow my lead. Eat new foods, admire the sky, and defeat someone's uncle? Okay, I just told all of you, don't eat anything. I love food, but do you think we really need to eat bugs or strange dishes to be good leaders? No. He's getting everybody. I struggle to see the relation. Oh, thank God. Beast is at least, he's aware. And I don't want to be rude, but I didn't understand all that stuff about stars and fireflies. Oh, thank God. Or the uncle. Okay, they're not down to take on Scar. I don't even have an uncle because he was just talking about Scar. He's very enthusiastic, but I don't think Timon was properly prepared for this talk. Yes, Beast! You know what, Beast? I'm impressed by you, Beast. You've come far. Ever since we've gotten rid of Belle, we've banished Belle. Sorry, he's really improved. I'm proud of him. Really, I am. Clearly not in the teen girl squad or a protector or anything like that, but like, I'm proud of him. You go, Beast. Phenomenal job. Phenomenal growth. Really, truly, I mean it. But like, literally, he poisoned the bugs. He poisoned the grubs. You know, I'm not seeing as much enthusiasm for my talk as I thought I would. Nobody seems more ready to rule. It's because nobody's eating your grubs, because I got to them first. You're not the ruler here, Timon. You don't have any power here. So if I were you, I would just scurry along somewhere else, back into your jungle where you can go mess up the ecosystem over there like you did in the Circle of Life video at Walt Disney World's Epcot, the Land Pavilion. I'll never forgive you for that. We have a long running beef, Timon and I. You really do. You really do. You lost, and you will continue to lose. So just salvage what dignity you have and leave. It kind of missed the mark.
No way!
What do you mean? It was perfect! Poor baby.
Yeah.
You keep thinking that. Let me think. Oh, I've got it. They just need to help apply my lessons to their own lives. No. And as the ruler of the valley, you should take the lead on this. I'm not joining your cult, Timon. Start by making He's gonna make me poison the valley. Something unique, something no one's ever tried before. Here I have recipes you can use. I don't know if I should trust this recipe. Are you doubting my Timon talk lesson? Yes. I'm just saying the recipe is very creative. I'm not sure who will be willing to eat this Timon. Hopefully no one. I've heard Anna and Elsa are pretty adventurous. They like pickled herring, and trust me, I've smelled some, and it's pungent. I bet they'd be happy to try some new foods and chase a new destiny. I can't make this up. I can't make this up. Do you see what's happening here? He's literally trying to start a cult and, like, grow the EyeLuminati army. And he's starting with Anna and Elsa. They were probably the weakest in the room. They are the weakest in the room. Yeah. Yeah, they are. Yeah, of course they are. Yeah, of course, Timon. Oh my god. If you say so, okay, I'll cook some of these dishes for Anna and Elsa. Right. Oh my god. It'll just be like when I fed Simba his first grub and turned him into a main character syndrome nuisance.
So long.
Jack. We have to protect Jack at all costs because Mirabelle and Kristoff are after Jack. I just know it. They're gonna come after him. And we have to protect him before they try to get him to join their forces and they learn more about the Nightthorns to take over the valley. I might have to tie Jack to me. I might have to attach him to my back. All right, gather the ingredients from the secret chamber. I'm sorry. Hold on. Hold on. Was I reading that correctly? We're gathering stuff, foods, from a secret chamber. One of those being night thorn mushrooms or something. Oh my god. I swear I didn't see any of that before I said the stuff about Nightthorns. Night mushroom. Oh my god. This is real. This is 100% reality. Look, they're already losing their minds. The valley's destroyed. It's the end. You know what? I'm just gonna have everybody drink the Kool-Aid to end the suffering. I'm gonna go make everybody Kool-Aid real quick. Be right back. I truly, truly pray that not a single person willingly eats. Not even willingly. Nobody eats this. Nobody eat this. They're bioluminescent, and we're gonna try to feed these to people. Oh my god. If anybody's gonna eat it, it's gonna be Anna. I have a little bit more hope for Elsa, but quite frankly, Anna was the weakest one in there. She was the weakest link. What is this present? Like, what's going on here? What is this, lead? This is just a big old rock of lead or something? Mulan, do not eat anything.
Ah, what a perfect day for training.
Okay, yeah, go training. Go training, Mulan, and don't even think about eating any food. None, zero. I cannot believe it's poisoned. It's poisoned, it's ruined. There's no way we can feed that to someone. Oh my god, but we're making two, right? We're making two, one for Anna, one for Elsa. Are they really gonna eat this? Please tell me they don't actually eat this. Please tell me Anna and Elsa won't drink the Kool-Aid. I don't know, who should we do first? Elsa's closest. Oh no, Kristoff is right there. Shoot, where's Anna? I was gonna ask if I could like hang out with her to take her somewhere private, but I'm not even getting that option. I don't want to give... Please tell me she doesn't eat it. Please tell me she doesn't eat it. Please don't eat this, Elsa. Do not
Hello, my friend.
Eat this. Oh my, well, thank you for the thought, but this isn't really to my taste. Thank God. We're safe. Eric, get away from me. I'm trying to save the valley from destruction. Okay, Eve's here. Eve's watching. We're good. We're safe. Yeah. I think Timon might be a little unclear about what makes a true leader. Yeah, he thinks that... Having you drink Kool-Aid, because I don't know if I can say the D word. He thinks that having you drink Kool-Aid is the answer.
I hope we can talk again soon.
Oh, Jafar is here too. Thank you so much, baby. My baby's here. What, Eric, you're gonna try to outdo Jafar? I'm happily married. I am so happily married. Oh, look, Jafar's trying to get on Kristoff's good side. He's constantly trying to manipulate them. It's hilarious. Okay, where'd Anna go? Because I saw her. All right, Anna. You're the weakest link. I don't know what to tell you. You are the weakest link, and I need you to be strong and not eat this. Don't eat it.
Hey, you're here.
Oh, wow, thanks. This tastes different and it's glowing.
This valley is pretty great.
Eric, Anna just got poisoned. Anna is now going to join the EyeLuminati, and quite frankly, it's ironic because her cheating ex-boyfriend, who's dating Mirabelle, is also in the EyeLuminati. So she's gonna have to see her cheating ex-boyfriend every single day. Maybe she didn't get a high enough dose. So maybe she's safe. I'm sorry, but I'm just not sure how this will help me be a better leader. It won't.
Wonder where I can
Don't eat any more. Throw
I'm
it away.
So glad we met.
Wonder where I can find some chocolate. Okay, she's trying to cleanse the palate. See, look at Jafar. Trying to manipulate Kristoff. I love this man. He is my Mr. Darcy. Running to my aid. He runs to my aid without me even seeing, you know?
You are a sight for sore eyes.
See, he manipulated him. And now Kristoff, like, forgot about Mirabelle. And now he's, like, trying to get me back. Unfortunately, this temporary mind control will fade because Jafar's powers, unfortunately, are not as strong here as they are in Agrabah. But he's doing his best, you know. I'll take a temporary mind control while he's still building his powers back up, you know. So at least we're safe from Kristoff for the next 5 minutes, maybe? 5 minutes tops. All right, Timon, where are you? Because we're supposed to be hanging out. So why do you keep running away? Bad news, Timon. Anna and Elsa didn't really feel like the meals helped them that much. What? Oh no, Timon, they didn't drink your Kool-Aid. That advice didn't make much sense. Yes? What do you mean? It means you're stupid. Simba ate some new food. Simba became king. It makes perfect sense. Timon. You can't just have people drinking the Kool-Aid and think that it's going to change their, like, brain chemistry and make them join the EyeLuminati. Because quite frankly, although Simba has main character syndrome, he's still not part of the EyeLuminati. Maybe Anna and Elsa don't need our help. He's protecting Anna and Elsa. Oh my god. He's probably walking over to Anna, making sure that she's okay. Jafar, you might need to mind control her just a little bit. Please mind control her. I'm sorry, everybody. I'm sorry. I can't see me leaving this man. I don't see in the future at any point what could happen that would make me and Jafar, like, that would come between Jafar and I for me to not love him or want nothing to do with him, because He just cured Anna. He gave her the temporary mind control to undo anything that Timon just did. I've never loved anybody more. Maybe Anna and Elsa don't need our help. We should focus our attention elsewhere. If he says Jack, if this man, no, it'll probably be Donald because he was the outlier. Okay, fine. We can forget the food because I know for a fact that sparkly sky dots were crucial to Simba and his journey. What are the stars have anything to do with anything?
Yes.
We need to bring some of those to Moana. You want to bring the stars to Moana. Okay, Timon. Good luck with that. I don't think that's going to work.
Yeah?
Trust me, it's guaranteed. Timon, you can't bring a star to anybody. All you gotta do is go where we meet and catch some fireflies that we can bring to Moana. Okay, so he's not talking about the stars. There must be some kind of poison in these special fireflies. These must be a special breed of fireflies that he used on Simba to manipulate him. Okay, I'll do that if you go check on Anna and Elsa just to make sure those dishes didn't make them sick. No, Timon, don't go anywhere near them. Okay, we got some. Okay, perfect, we're done. Look at Jafar trying to brainwash Mirabelle. See, do you see this? But also look, Jafar, sweetie, I think the brainwash wore off of Kristoff because he was just over at Olaf. Oh my god, now Vanellope's after Olaf. What are they doing to Olaf? Jafar, baby, if you could go check in on Olaf for me, I would really appreciate it. Where is Moana? Oh, she's right over here. Do not touch the fireflies. Don't let them out. Don't let them out because there's something wrong with them. Okay, I have a timer on this lid. And it will go off in approximately 2 hours. Just take the fireflies back to the Lion King realm, leave the jar there, it'll open in 2 hours, they won't die, they'll be fine, because it's not their fault. It's not the fireflies' fault that they're like poisonous to humans or whatever, but just don't touch them. Just leave it there. They'll be freed in 2 hours. I don't want to be rude, but these aren't stars. They're fireflies. Yeah, I know. Trying to help out Timon. Really, I'm not. Oh, right. With this Timon talk, yeah. He's really trying so hard. Sorry, Jamie. If it helps, you can tell him the fireflies are really pretty. They are very pretty. Also very deadly. So just leave the jar and run. Why can I never find this stupid meerkat, even though I'm literally hanging out with him? Unfortunately, the fireflies didn't really resonate with Moana. She did say they were pretty, though. I guess she already looks at lots of sparkly sky dots for wayfinding. Maybe that wasn't the advice she needed. No. This isn't going so well, is it? No, it's not. Just like I said. I was right. You were wrong. You're a stupid narcissist. Go back to the jungle. No, please get discouraged. It isn't going great, but we can turn it all around by you turning around and leaving the valley. I like how you think, and I have an idea. Oh, God. Let me think. Simba had to defeat his uncle. So what we need is a nephew and uncle to compete in something. Scrooge McDuck and Donald are uncle and nephew. That's perfect. I heard they had an argument earlier. If we help Donald, maybe he can rise up and become a great leader in the valley. Oh my god. you're never going to convince Donald. You won't, Timon. You have nothing that Donald wants, okay? He may have a bad temper, but he's like a chaotic good. Well, I don't know. He also is kind of a chaotic neutral. It's not going to work, Timon. All right, I'll go talk to Donald and see how we can help.
Guess what, Jamie? I found a treasure map today. Only problem is, my Uncle Scrooge thinks he should get whatever the map leads to.
Oh, is that what you two were arguing about?
I gotta find the treasure before he does. Could you help me?
Honestly, Donald, yeah, because Scrooge has enough. Sure, Timon thinks if you beat your uncle at something, it will make you a better leader. He's a fabulous leader already. This is a perfect opportunity to test that. Donald's perfect already.
Here, take this treasure map and let's get started before Uncle Scrooge wins.
Oh wait, there's three treasures.
I wonder who the ruler of this valley is.
I'm the ruler, you idiot. Oh my god.
Shows that everybody's special in their own way.
Run. Run. Oh god, she was like chasing after me. Did you see that? Kristoff, go get your girl. She's right there. Ooh, we got lots of treasures here. That's fun. Oh, Donald's here. Hi, Donald. Here we go. All right, Donald, sweetie. We got all the treasures.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. You did it, Jamie. You found all the treasures before Uncle Scrooge. So, does this make me a king or something?
You've always been a king. Because I don't feel like a king. Actually, I don't feel different at all. I don't think Timon knows what he's talking about. They were all too smart for Timon and his narcissism. I'm so proud of them. Notice how not a single member of the EyeLuminati was in there. Did we notice that? Your tactics aren't working, Timon. I don't understand. We did everything Simba did. Why doesn't everyone appreciate my lessons because you're a stupid narcissist? I have to be honest with you, Timon. I think you might be mixing up exactly what helped Simba become a great leader.
No way. Go talk to Simba and Pumbaa. They'll tell you everything I said is completely true.
No, they won't. I know my baby would never do me dirty. What do you want, Eric? Get away from me. I'm never leaving Jafar. It's not happening. Look, Jafar is taking care of Olaf for me, finally. Thank you, baby. You're the best. Okay, where? We gotta find Simba and Timon. I have noticed that the lions, all of the Lion King characters, have been spending a lot of time in the Sunlit Plateau. Like, they're there constantly. And I like that. Like, I wonder if they're testing out, like, having the characters be in certain places a little more often. That way it adds to their personality. Hi, Biffle. How are you today, sweetie?
Everyone here be so... Now, what's the word? Nice?
Well, in all fairness, Scar, not everyone here is nice. This place sure is busy. When does everybody take a break? That Timon talk sure was interesting. Timon really knows how to work the crowd. Yeah, I agree. Maybe not in a positive way, but I agree. It hasn't been very successful so far. Oh, maybe he just needs to practice. You're really supportive of him, aren't you? Of course, after all, friendship's the most important thing there is. And when Timon's your buddy, you've got a friend for life. You are so sweet, Pumbaa. I do wish you had better taste in friends, though.
Oh, hello!
It's because Jafar and I raised him right. And unfortunately, when you do that, it could make them prone to narcissists. If you don't help them soon enough.
Oh, look, he's talking to Scar. Oh, hey, Simba.
How dare you push my best friend? So sweet. Look at that. My best friend and my child. I love it. I love it so much. Simba, you're ruining this. You're ruining this for me. So Timon's having a bit of a hard time with the Timon talk, huh? He doesn't really know what he's doing. Moana, why are you death glaring me? Did you touch the fireflies? Shoot, Moana touched the fireflies. She didn't listen to me. We'll get Jafar to help her out. I think he just needs a reminder about how he actually helped me back then. Probably not at all. It might not seem like it, but Timon is really brave. Yeah, that's because he's a narcissist and he has no sense of self. He has no true sense of self. He thinks He's invincible. When push comes to shove, he'll put himself on the line for his friends only when he knows he's going to survive. Would you say that's how he helped you out on your own journey? Huh? Yeah, he stood by my side during the hardest days of my life. He taught me how to relax, but also how to be a loyal and true friend. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. He just needs to be reminded of that. I don't want to feed his ego. At all. Pumbaa baby, could you do mommy a favor and go feed Timon's ego? Because he's used to hearing it from you, so it won't really affect anything. Oh my god. So did you talk to Simba and Pumbaa? I did, and they had something interesting to say. Well, don't leave me in suspense. Your friendship is the most important thing, I guess. Anyone can eat some weird food, aka Kool-Aid, or look up at the stars, but what makes you special? We don't need to tell him how he's special, because he's not. It's how you stand by those you love. Oh my god. He doesn't love anybody but himself. Being a great leader isn't all about the flashy stuff you've been talking about. What a leader needs the most is help of friends they trust the most. Oh god, now he's gonna go manipulate a whole bunch of people. Whoa, I never thought of it like that. Thanks, Jamie. Now I can rework my Timon talk and have it actually be helpful. Great, we've given him ideas on how to manipulate the public. In fact, I'm gonna go do it right now. See you later, Jamie. Oh my god. Well, things are just getting worse every single day. They really are. Timon, you are the villain of the valley. Truly, truly you are. You are at the top of the pyramid. And quite frankly, I'm terrified of what's to come next. If you guys enjoyed the video, feel free to give it a thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel for more absolute Disney Dreamlight Valley madness. And I will see you guys in the next one. Bye! Making dreams come true.